Well, if there is a doctor of horsemanship and a doctor of horse relationships, Dr. J is right here too. Good morning. Good to see you again, sir.
Good morning, Kenny. Awesome to be here.
Awesome to have you back for Horsefest happening this weekend. So bring the whole family out. We're at Lake Metroparks Farmpark. Okay, we were talking about this obstacle course as using it as a great example of the relationship between horse and rider and the trust that you guys develop over the course of, you know, it depends. It's organic. It depends on the horse, right?
Exactly. A lot of the obstacles around here kind of provoke some natural fears in horses, mm-hmm. Just based on their instincts, based on the fact that their vision is different from our own.
Right.
But through working through these obstacles, we build that confidence and build that trust over time.
All right. I'm going to follow you a little bit and watch what you do.
Yep.
And as we get ready to go, why is that important to build that trust with the horse when you're doing day-to-day activities that probably a horse wouldn't really do?
Right. Well, that's kind of the thing is, you know, we use horses for a lot of tasks, whether it's a lot of cases, you know, even today, even though it's 2023, mm-hmm. there's still a lot of cowboys working on ranches where jobs you can only get done with a horse really
right.
well that a four-wheeler or a vehicle can't do. So in order to get along with our horses and
whoops. There we go. See, that's good. See?
Yeah. In order to get along with these horses better, we need to have that control. We need to have that relationship built with them to mm-hmm. do those jobs.
Excellent. All right.
I'll take you through this here.
Yeah. I'm looking. I'm like, okay.
It's a natural fear for a horse. Just push right on through that there.
Okay. So I'm telling the horse, trust me, I know it looks scary. I know what I'm doing. I'm a professional. So I need to remain calm too, don't I?
Exactly.
All right.
And, you know, if the horse is a little bit wary, you can circle the object, give him a chance to look at it, but like, confident there.
He did a good job. Okay.
Nice.
Excellent. All right.
Then we got this mailbox obstacle, which is a common fear of horses, especially trail horses. You know, you go ride past your neighbor's house, horse spooking at that mailbox. We want to make sure they're comfortable up here. Right next to that object.
No, it's not going to hurt them. Trust me. Da, da, da. And horses, you said their vision is different from ours. So what we would take for granted seeing, they might not, correct?
Precisely. Horses, their eyes are really sharp. They pick up movement easily, but they can't focus like our eyes can. They don't have the depth perception. So a lot of times, especially when you're moving, it's hard for them to get a sense of what something is, or if you're crossing a puddle or you're going through something, how deep it is. You know, they'll kind of be more wary of that.
So they have to trust you.
Precisely. Just like this, you know, kind of push through that there, even though it's kind of a silly sensation with those noodles
mm-hmm.
and they can't quite tell, they can still trust us to go through
trust
that.
Me. Trust me.
Yeah.
Trust me. Atta boy.
Just like that.
I think he smells the donut. All right. When will you do your demonstrations throughout the weekend?
Well, we'll be out here Saturday and Sunday, starting mm-hmm. at 11 o'clock and then again at 2:30 in the afternoon.
Excellent.
All right. Well, he made it look easy. Trust me. You see, that was on me. It wasn't a horse. I take full responsibility for knocking down the little obstacle there. All right. We're going to go back to you guys in the studio. Lake Metroparks Farmparks are happening there at Horsefest. And I just love hanging out mm-hmm. with these people. It's so much fun.
Good stuff.
All right. Cowboy and cowgirl back here in the studio.
All right. Thank you.